Have you ever wondered how fireflies glow? It's simply a gene. We extract that gene and use it to make proteins glow. With our microscope, we can see minute movements of proteins inside cells. That's what I'm interested in, how cells work and how one small protein change can cause pandemonium. I work with yeast, learning about biomolecule recycling, learning how cells eat, analyzing the traffic within a cell, and studying the toxicity of nanomaterials once they are internalized into cells. We've made the big discoveries in our lab. Backed by a grant from the National Science Foundation, we found a powerful protein named dynamin that is involved in the cellular eating process, which we call endocytosis. We've also discovered that dynamin travels to various parts of the body and has many important functions. For instance, if dynamin is mutated and it is supposed to be regulating traffic within a cell, chaos ensues. Or if dynamin isn't present at the time of endocytosis, the cell's vesicle does not work. Thanks to the firefly, we can see this. My students, collaborators, and I know that it goes beyond yeast. A modified protein in a human body can cause traffic to flow in unwanted ways, causing health issues like Alzheimer's disease and other neurological conditions. The fact that something so simple, the same yeast that makes bread and beer, can lead to a medical breakthrough is incomprehensible to many. But by using these simple organisms, we can understand how these cellular processes work so that someday we can better treat or even prevent these disorders in humans. And it could all but from studies using an unlikely pairing, fireflies and yeast.